That was definitely a crazy boss fight. Hopefully there's a bench before next encounters. Just follow stench. Yeah, I guess we can use some regular cures and until we can find a bench. Things which he inspired too. That thing's pretty, I couldn't block because I was using disorder. Yeah, I can tell this nail bat actually kind of sucks. Again, it's supposed to be just for crits, but its regular attack in Punisher mode is this big old like bat swing. It takes forever to do. Let's go and heal Tifa again. Anything? In a box, the Mako shard. This doesn't go anywhere. Yeah, it's a dead end. Of course, it's a puzzle here, right? Guess you can drain the water and go down. At least we don't actually have to go into the waters. Jeez, ladies, wait for me. I saw this materia back there. Or not materia, just something purple. Purple chest. This be a pair of feathered gloves for Tifa. Nice. She's getting a lot of new weapons here. Not even done with the Sonic Strikers. Actually, what was the criteria? Stagger an enemy. Holy crap, that might take a while. Then I guess I'll just do the normal stuff. Strike with attack or strong attack after switching modes. Oh, that's easy to do. I should have been doing that the whole time. Oh, wait, does this do anything? Does this close it back up? It does. Is there a point to this? Oh, well. Not actually quite sure. I guess I'll just wait. Huh. There's actually a point of closing the gate. Unless to make it so people can't follow us or something. Unsure. Oh, bench. Benching a record of some sort. Oh, nothing special, it looks like. Except for this. maybe. Ishii. Oh, I think that's the right way to go. Let's go the other way. See if there's a treasure chest or something. Maybe just a fight? Nothing. There's a crab or something right there. Magic. Oh wow. That thunder totally wiped it out. Oh, that's the way out. 1 second, girls. Seems to be treasure over here. Probably another fight. Is there a point to this? I have this feeling that we're actually going to be able to thwart them from crushing Sector 7, but who knows? That's just wishful thinking, actually, but we'll see. It's dark as crap. Definitely not lying, but we'll see. I don't think he's lying for sure, because again, that's what happens in the original. But again, just I wonder what's gonna happen this time around. Breaker. To make off, it still works. Let's try it out. Yeah, the lights turned on. Fights though. Well, there's two of them. Ow. The crap. Maybe fire is the one that. They get proficiency. Not yet. Guess I'll just keep using disorder then. So I think just trying to do what wait. Why do I want to turn this? I see. So I can potentially get some items, I guess. Yep, looks like a materia. Dependent materia. Hopefully it's a maybe all, maybe? No, key to the sewers, never mind. Kage? So I guess I need that key regardless. Anything on this side? There's a switch. Material on this side, right? Treasure chest and some boxes. Okay, interesting how the girls don't come down here. Like I said, that just means there's no fight. Pretty much if the party comes with you, then there's a fight that could break out. But yeah, I have a feeling maybe, okay, we don't lose Sector 7. Maybe we can actually roam around the other parts of Midgar without worrying about anything. Didn't see anything back here. Nope. Alright, let's get out of here. Get to Sector 7 before it's too late. Hey, don't bump into me. Yeah, where are we? Got more of these, whoops. Get over here. Home run. I think I need to pull the thing before I can go down there. This might look like it's locked on the other side, yeah. Also see a material over there. Because these buttons or switches open the sluice gates. Closed to its gates, Sluice gates. Oh, there's enemies behind, of course. Ah, what? Oh, I missed. Oh, oh. Ice is its weakness. Wait, what? Freaking poison bath or something. Switch weapons out. I don't really like Nail Bat. I think I would. But best thing I believe is in Hard Edge. Due to all the power. Let's see what else I can add to this thing. Attack power. Just attack power. Magic. Attack damage boost. Nice. Alright, let's go ahead and switch to Tifa. Am I proficient with this yet? Nope. Unless I can take an ability or spell. And how far along is Tifa actually? Not too far. 60%. Is there a ladder? Yes, there is. Can we crush it? Okay, I'm not sure about that, actually. Materia. What we got here? A little more poison. Oh! So that's why we brought it down, so we can actually cross it. I was like, I don't know what we actually did there, but now we found out. We can actually walk across it. Proficiency. Nice. And she's done with it. Alright, let's see what this does. It does unleash a flurry of powerful strikes. Increase the strength of next command executed. Ooh. Follow up with offensive ability or magic after using the weapon ability. Oh, the only problem is this doesn't allow us to connect any of our materia. But at the same time, let's look at the upgrades first before I say anything else, because I might be able to link them. Let's see. Let's try to link them first before I do anything. New materia slot. Oh, it doesn't link them. That sucks. That is quite alright. I'm gonna add some power. Speed. That's pretty good. ETB attack rate. Or charge rate. Rear assault. That's gonna help. Definitely get these attack powers. that's all I have for right now. Should probably switch the materia out then if I can't link them together. Whoops. How we do it. You got this, girl. It's probably definitely harder for her because she's not like super fit like Tifa and Cloud. It's like, don't fall into the sewer water. Bonding moments. Oh no. Can't go back. That would have helped, but Tifa's already there. Well, I also love how they have the accessory on. Cause she has the gauntlet now. So what about the champion belt? Cloud's supposed to have it. Is that the champion belt? Pretty sure that's just his normal clothes, right? Interesting. Yep, no going back now. Something over here? No. It's part of the scenery. Shopping. Coasters. Yep, I don't think we're saving Sector 7. Going.
Ooh. 離さないでね。一気にあげるよ。
just realized Tifa's gauntlets are the new gauntlets I just equipped her. I didn't miss anything, but it seemed like I could get anything else. Ooh, bench, you know what that means. Boss fight. Or something big is about to go down. And yeah, pretty sure it's gonna be the plate come down, fight, or whatever event. Yeah, I don't even think so. I can get the show on the road. That definitely looks like a fight room. Some treasure this way. Maybe a fight. No fight. Yes, fight. Star shower. Holy crap. Damn, Tifa. So that should be a limit break or something. Cause that's too strong. To, I think they're weak against ice. Oh, but I don't have the link anymore. Again, pools of acid or whatever. I'm down. Alright, at least Air's smart. Of course, all she can do is cast magic, but still. That was really stupid of me. Let's see. This looks like a dead end, so let's go this way. Maybe it isn't dead end. Let's go back. Unless it loops around, then it would have been fine, but I don't know if it does.
Oh,
chest. Alright, so we go down, then around. Here's this one. What is this? Warding. What does that do? Warding. Reduce debuff duration by 25%. But only links with certain ones, I see. Pretty much should run up to the enemy first before starting to press the attack buttons, because otherwise, that's a lot of boxes. So otherwise, you just start swinging, or in case of Tifa, you just start punching the air. So this is definitely a dead end, right? Alright, so good thing I went back this way. I was about to progress without getting all these items. I feel like some of these items I could probably live without, but again, you want to at least have that option if you want to use the items. So I'm saying, I feel like we should definitely be able to go back to the other sectors and stuff. We definitely would be able to go back to Sector 5, because that was a thing in the original 2. But for sure, Tifa. It's a convenience lever right here. Though I guess it's a puzzle. Must be bust. Blockage. Yeah, pump. True.
Yes.
Splitting
up. Airs, open the valve. Tilt L, or left stick up to open the valve. The needle will start to swing right to left. Have Tifa work the pump. Work that pump. While the needle is moving, repeatedly hit X to expand the target range. As the indicator hand swings back to the right, tilt down within target range to close the valve. So honestly, we could probably not even have Tifa open it that far. Oh. Oh, I wasn't even paying attention. Whoops. Pump that. Pop it. Easy. Oh, you do it three times? Pump three times. Of course, it gets harder to... Ah, crap. It goes very fast. And I was pretty... I was matching pretty hard on the axe. Oh, I see it makes it easier. I think. It was like that, the Air's House little mini game where you have to sneak out. After two mistakes, they actually like clear the area for you, so you just gotta leave. Yeah. So even though I was like mashed really fast, I couldn't really get. Oh my gosh! Holy crap! I didn't think it would be that fast. Jesus. It's gonna make it easier. Got it. Nice. Do we have to worry about the other side? Or is it just this one side? Nicely done. Go team! Team waifus! Waifu power. Oh. Ouch. Oh, jeez. Fine. Crap, what the hell is going on? Oh, did Cloud get toted? He did get toted. Leapfrog. Oh, I got turned into a frog too. Holy crap. Oh no! Like this, Cloud. Holy crap. You got frogged and it's like screwed me over. I only have one. Eat it. Frog fighting. Holy crap, that was very scary actually. I got screwed by that frog. Thing is, I don't remember a place where I can buy maiden's kisses. Ah, dang it. You too? Time to sleep. Oh, we all sleep? Holy crap. This is what sucks in this game, like, you don't wake back up after getting hit. See? It's like time-based instead of actual, like, the way it should be. Stuff I got cheating. Let's really put these shoes on somebody, the sleep shoes. Kinda want to though. 3 strength isn't too much. Frog. Frog thing's gonna be really annoying. Get out of here, guys. Can't fight all these guys. We're not delicious. Soldier for you. I feel like that little swarm of whatever is kind of unnecessary. But definitely, yeah, those Sagahin are very annoying to fight, to say the least. Looks like another weapon right there. It has begun. That's rude, I think. Yep. I recognize that bald head anywhere. This is Bush. He has fangs. If only that were true. Let's use his bench. Oh, there, it healed me. Whoops. I didn't even look at that. Interesting how they have a bench here, though. If they're gonna heal me, there's no point. I'm assuming there's no, albums. Actually, can I buy... Nope. See, can I buy any maiden kisses? Because getting frogged is really annoying, but I guess we don't have to worry about getting frogged anymore. Assuming the darkness is where all the treasure is going to be. Scary stories are scary, that's for sure. Ladies, I'll lead the way. Purple boxes. That was a little creepy, actually. Handprints all over them. Excuse me. It should be this weapon box over here. Because it's purple. Misro rod for Eddie's. Fire an energy burst that hits multiple times. Holy crap. Cost 2 ATB. So I guess it's similar to a Cloud's thingamabob. Hard edge. Let's see. How do I want to stat this? Oh wow, it only has 2 slots. Sorry, has a lot of magic actually. Holy crap. Wow, look at all that magic. Of course, this will cost a whole bunch, that's why. Alright, probably just get these 2 magic powers. Yeah. Maximum MP. That's definitely gonna be a really good it's going to be Fabled Mage's weapon of choice, Mithril Rod. I'm not really ready to use it yet, so just wait off on that. I didn't even notice his ladder here the first time. Shower is complete. I guess right now Metal Knuckles will actually be the best. Oh, I guess I can put the I didn't really use barrier. I should have. Yeah, 5 magic points. That's pretty high. Let's take off poison, haven't been using it. Let's add on barrier. I feel like I really need to use barrier. Still creepy, these boxes with handprints all over it. Oh, we're gonna have to fight those spirit things again. Was there anything else this way before I go? No. It's very creepy. So they don't put jump scares in here. No, they kind of did a little bit of a jump scare. Oh, there's a little wisp. Oh, Jesus. Crap. These are very annoying. What? Holy crap. Stop. They really want to kill Eris. Jesus. talking about that one, so let's go here first. One gill. Wrong way. Sorry, I didn't know. So I get for exploring. I can't see their attack animation. Again, they're just beating up on Paris. Oh my gosh. Holy crap! Please. Stop. So annoying. It's annoying when they interrupt. That's like the worst part of this. Look at that shit. Teaming up on her. I used it like 3 or 4 times just now. I wonder how much proficiency. Went up by a lot. Nice. But holy crap, they like swarmed Eris pretty much. It's pretty BS if you ask me. Ooh, materia. I'm sure there's gonna be a fight over here. Or not. It's cool. HP up. I haven't been using HP ups till now. Yeah, I think, especially in the hard playthrough or something, I'm definitely going to make sure we don't kind of double up on certain magics unless it's like a boss or something I'm anticipating. Because I don't think it's really worth not having the HP ups and stuff. I really need to level those up. Creepy. Oh, that means there's gonna be a fight. Holy junk. That's a lot of graffiti. Go through.
Itemio.
Oh, so this is where this goes out my thing. Can't fight if you're holding on to me. Oh, he's so cute. Oh, this is a cute section. He just like breaks free, that's it. I thought we were gonna like all walk in together. Linked arms. Oh well. Oh. It's very creepy. Pretty sure Eris can see him. Because she's in tune with the live stream and stuff. She's an ancient after all. Oh. They're all haunted, or turned to fiends, maybe? Oh, they're like, don't talk to them! Ghost of Weekend's fire, right? Yep. Weak against resistance to all of it. Ah, yeah, he went immune again. Ouch, holy crap. There's that. I see the other ones ran away. We destroyed the hostile ghost, but this one, it's a monster. Has a cry face on it. Whoa. You gonna drop it? Yep. Get out of there, guys. Oof. Oof. That was close. What's up, Angel? You see Cloud suplex the ghost train, your life will be complete. Is that a reference to Final Fantasy VI? Ow. Because there's some train suplexing in that game for sure. How you been? I haven't seen you in a while, Angel. Oh, what happened? Oh, stunned. Ow. I hate this thing. It's dead. Place got blocked off. Anything about cursed comments that are technically the truth. It'd be fitting for this area. Oh, that was a little creepy. Oh, birthday sex is an act of celebrating the fact your parents had sex. Oh, so they did make this a ghost train scenario. That's from Final Fantasy VI. They definitely did do this in the original. All aboard the graveyard. I thought we were actually gonna like go on a ghost train. Can't get that. You wouldn't doubt it. What's this? Power. Yeah, it is interesting how they're expanding all these like small events from the original into bigger scenarios. Door's locked from the inside. So we're going this way then. Whoa. Wasn't creepy at all. I'm assuming this way is not locked. Of course, more of these cursed boxes, the handprints. Say, why'd you find him for? Ow. Oh yeah, it's cost two. Let's go and use it. Ray of Judgment. Wow. Oh, I thought they both died. Could you imagine an alternative universe where darkness straight up burns you if you fully enveloped in darkness? That would be interesting. Kind of like a unholy light of sorts. Though I guess if everything's flip-flopped, then the darkness would be the holy light if everything's backwards. But it's pretty interesting because we always like think about how the light is like form of salvation and stuff, of comfort. But you get too close to the light, you get burned. Funny enough, the darkness doesn't burn you like that. It does more of a subtle corruption instead. That is the power of magic. We're fighting. I think the way he just opens the doors, like, invites kind of creepiness. How many material does Cloud Sword hold? It actually depends on the sword. If you check the different swords he has, they'll have their own amount. And the thing is, in this game, you can actually upgrade your weapons. And then some weapons allow you to add more materia slots, while some weapons don't. Or at least not in the early cores. So every weapon has sub-cores, and of course the main core. And you spend SP points to unlock whatever you want. And this hard edge, does that look like it has any materia slots, actually, like you can't unlock any? But if you look at, say, Buster Sword. So this one actually has 4 cores, but this one actually has a materia slot you can unlock, which I already have. Where is it? There it is. Oh, no, that's not it. There it is. So originally I only had 2, but... well, I can actually unlock another one if I wanted to. So you could farm money and upgrade your equipment indefinitely. The way the weapons upgrade is actually by level itself, so you don't really have to grind for money. You just had to grind for experience. Because when you level up, you gain more SP. And once your SP reaches a certain amount, which, let's see, if you look at the bottom left, yeah, there's a weapon level 4. There are 5 segments, and I'm like halfway, a little past halfway. Well, can't tell if I'm halfway. Because once I get 110 SP, then I'll unlock the next weapon level, and then a new subcore will open up. So what is the level cap? 199,999. Usually it's just 99, or 100 actually. But yeah, I doubt it will be that high. 99 or 4 nines. It's either going to be 99 or 100. And again, I don't know exactly how far this game goes. I know I'm a little past halfway. And I don't know if you knew, but they're deciding to split this game into multiple parts. Kind of like a couple year project, I guess. So this is like the first phase. And I feel like it ends right after you face Rufus, I think. I'm not 100% sure. I know there's around 16-ish chapters. And I'm on chapter 11. Oh, they want to ride the DLC train, of course. But I feel like they're not going to be DLC. I think they're going to be standalone entries, I think. So that's gonna be interesting too. But yeah, I've heard there's people already griping about that fact that this is... I mean, they already announced that it was gonna be episodic release, so I don't know. People just like to get angry even though they've been told what the plan was. But I know not everyone's angry, obviously, but I know some of them are. It's kind of sad, because again, they didn't have to make this remake, but they did. Yeah, I think it's going to be kind of like what they did with 13. Though 13, I feel like Part 1 was pretty much a full game, like they didn't have to do the sequels to that one. But it's as if they were stalling for time or they really wanted to tell that story. But... oh gosh. really hate these enemies. They stagger you when you're trying to attack them. Oh, I just totally whizzed. What if Cloud just dies 10 minutes into the game? Replaced with a feline female robot. Holy crap. Michael Bay style. Transformers. I think I only watched the first Transformers. Maybe the second one too. But I didn't watch them all. Yeah, they could have. Well, I don't even know. I think if they did that, they might as well just write or make a whole new game. There's really no point in remaking this title. If they're just gonna get rid of all of the main story pieces. And I feel like that's kind of not necessarily what they did, but the Star Ocean series. They, wait, where am I? Am I at the beginning? Oh no, I am on the other side, okay. I was confused for a second. I was like, where am I? Couple of those boxes are creepy. It's definitely nice that they're giving me Moogle medals, but I feel like when we return to Sector 5, we're gonna get to be able to use another tier of like items, or like buy another tier of items. Mega potion. Definitely don't need those. This only means, again, a fight's coming up. You can tell when they're just letting you buy all this stuff. But yeah, it definitely brought a lot of stuff to the modern era with the benches and the vending machines. Stuff like that. Just these little things they added. Let's see, I think I did explore everything. I'm just going to go inside the control room. Because this segment in the original was very short. You just walked through the train graveyard and moved a couple trains and then you're out. But here, we're doing a whole new level, pretty much. It's a materia mod where it makes every sword impact cause an powerful explosion. Not to my knowledge, I don't think. I think the best you can do is set elemental materia so that your weapons do elemental damage. But I don't know about big explosions. Alright. Oh! Oh yeah, I forgot. It's supposed to be a big boss battle. Tifa? Why are you so scared? You're like stronger than probably both of us, to be honest. Cloud just has a big ol' sword. Crap. There's a bunch of ghosts. But Eris is, now she hasn't revealed to us that she's an ancient, or like, whatever. We let the demons everywhere. Oh jeez. They're fusing into one. Holy cow. Oof. Actually reminds me of Death Gaze from Final Fantasy VI. I don't have time for your shit. Oh. Let's see. Wow. Wow, it actually knocks down the barricades. Oh, right away. Oh, it's pressured actually. Dang it. Missed my shot. Ow. About to get hit. He has to rearrange the room. That's pretty cool, actually. Use spells. Actually, I don't know if it's weak against fire. It is. Of course it is. It's a ghost. Wait, there's. Use your arcane ward. Silence, I forgot. See, I think if it is visible like this, I'm actually supposed to... Oh, dang it. Holy crap. What the heck? Like, I'm getting stunned. If it's visible, then I have to use physical attacks. If it is... Whoa. Ah. I was hoping I could, block it somehow? I don't know. It's such a bit silly that I thought I could block it. Ouch. Staggered. Oh, it died. Oh, it didn't die. I thought it died. One second. I see your question. Beat this boss first, so address it. Whoa, that's creepy as hell. That sucks too, I like just staggered it, so it's back to normal. Oh, I have a limit break actually. Ow. What? useless right now. She can't do physical attacks. Oh my gosh, I ran into that. Nice. And then Ares just jumps right in there. Oh, I see. Subversion materia. That was fun. Outside and use the bench. So that battle wasn't too bad. There's been worse boss fights for sure. So you have a question. You had a custom pistol made for you and it was 13 millimeters. Would you test it out? 13 is pretty big. You know, I've only been to a gun range once in my life. We shot, I remember what we shot, 12 gauge, 9 gauge. One of each. Wait, where's the way out? Also, speaking of shooting guns, I watched a YouTube video today about a dude. Well, first, it started with me looking at a video of him shooting bow and arrow through riot shields that he bought for like 50 bucks a piece, which is pretty cheap for a riot shield, but it's pretty cool too. He used three different types of bows and a crossbow. Is this the way back? Nope, not that way. He used a recurve bow. It didn't quite pierce much. Then he... I forgot if he used the broadhead or something on it. But yeah, it pierced through the front shield. And then didn't make it to the second one. And then he used a composite bow, which is, I thought was pretty cool. yeah. Guns are nice. I just, don't have the funds to really get one or play with them at the shooting range. But yeah, it's pretty cool. The other video I saw was him trying to shoot through gun safes. Wait. What are you trying to do? Street. Yeah, they used all sorts of guns and different types of ammo too. Try to dodge. 50 millimeters is point, like half an inch pretty much, or 1.3 centimeters. Yeah, definitely like big ass bullets. So I can only imagine. Marlene? Really so cute. Speak of dad, we're talking about Barrett, because her real dad is missing. Bench for no reason. And I think it's actually a good time to stop.